And with the dog days of summer upon us, we are in the heart of tick season. While some think they're just a summer nuisance, they can pose a serious health risk. That's why researchers at A.T. Still University in Kirksville, Missouri, are working with the Missouri Department of Conservation to collect thousands of ticks from all over the state, and they want your help. What are they hoping to learn? We're talking it over with Deborah Hudman, who is a senior research associate in the Microbiology and Immunology Department at TSU. Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you for joining us this morning. Well, you started this program a few months ago. Where do you want people to send you the ticks that they find from all over the state? How many have you received so far?
So this began in April 1st, and I've received over 12,000 ticks.
12,000. One would think that that would be enough for you to conduct your research, but you want more, right?
Yes. So ticks are seasonal in the fact that you get different species at different times of year. And so of that 12,000, for instance, the black-legged tick, which you just showed on your screen, those I've only received 79 of. So we still have a lot of counties that we need to fill that data in.
And the idea is to figure out where they came from. And your goal is to help area doctors throughout the state figure out that if somebody is sick from a tick bite, you can better help them treat it. Isn't that the ultimate goal?
Yes. So different species carry different pathogens. So the idea is to, at the county level, know what species are present, and then also test a subset of those that I'm receiving for various human pathogens. And that way you can inform both the public and our healthcare practitioners on what diseases are in their area.
The most common, I think, disease from tick bite, I think, is Lyme disease, but what is more prevalent here in Missouri? What types of illnesses can people get from a tick bite?
Ehrlichiosis is probably Missouri's worst kept secret. So Ehrlichiosis, I've tested 115 ticks today, and 38% of those are positive for Ehrlichiosis.
So if we want to participate in this study, how do we gather them after we see them on the grass, off of our bodies, off of our pets?
Yeah, any of those are acceptable. I prefer if they ship them live. Basically, there's a form. If you go to atsu.edu, there should be a U there, /ticks, then the instructions and a submission form are all available. They can also just email me, and I can send those to them. But basically, you take the tick, you put it in a Ziploc bag with something that's has a little moisture, either a cotton ball or a piece of paper towel or a blade of grass. And then you put all that into a second Ziploc bag in an envelope and mail it to ATSU in Kirksville.
All right. So when do you think you might see some results, some tangible results where statewide physicians will be able to use these results?
Well, we're going to be collecting till September next year, so that way we can get all the seasons. My guess is by summer next year, there probably be some very good information out there.
You are doing fascinating work, and better you than me. That's all I got to say. Thank you for joining us, Deborah. We really appreciate it. And for folks who want to help with this study, it's statewide. Collect your ticks and send them in. We've got all the information you need on our website, as well as our Fox 2 mobile app, the address, everything you need, where to send it. So thanks for joining us. Have a good day. Stay safe out there. Time to take a break. We'll be right back.